Well, what happens to the Miami, Sean, is that she will be stripped of everything usable. Then she'll be towed to Puget Sound, where she'll be recycled. Now, today was a chance for crew members, both past and present, to say their goodbyes.
Strike commissioning pennant and lower the ensign. Aye, sir.
In an auditorium at the Portsmouth Naval Shipyard, the USS Miami's service to her country came to an end. Speakers talked about the reputation of the Miami as a hot boat, one that always answered the call. That service was cut short back on May 23rd of 2012 when an intentional fire was set in the ship. The damage was estimated at nearly $500 million, and the Navy determined it wasn't cost-effective to repair the sub, which was commissioned in 1990. Today, the Miami's legacy was recalled as speakers said, "Make no mistake, this was a fighting lady who did her country proud."
She launched strikes against Iraq in the opening salvo of Operation Desert Fox, then sped over 5,000 miles to the Adriatic Sea to launch strikes against Serbian forces in Kosovo, becoming the first submarine since World War II to fire ordnance during combat operations in two different theaters.
As for the Miami's crew, well, they'll be dispersed to other ships or subs or jobs around the Navy. All the crew will be gone by December of this year. Reporting live in Portsmouth, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.